Dear learners, so far we have seen ABC analysis. So in this tab 1 you will see ABC analysis that we have done. In tab 2 you will see XYZ analysis that we did, and in tab 3 it is simply the only raw material. It is only the product code that is taken in the column A, and in column B it's just a lookup to see which category this product falls into, ABC category, and in column C you will see the lookup to see in which category this product falls into, XYZ category. Now on column D you will see there are 9 different possibilities of having ABC and XYZ combination. So you will see AX, AY, AZ, BX, BY, BZ and CX, CY, CZ. So these are different combinations of selective inventory control method. Now, why we use this combination of ABC and XYZ? So we have already discussed that ABC analysis alone is not helpful in inventory planning. And I would also say XYZ analysis alone is also not helpful for effective inventory planning. And that's why having a combination of ABC and XYZ is widely used across the industry. Now, why it is widely used? We will understand that with some examples. Now there are two examples. The first example is you may have a product whose value is really high for your inventory or for your entire demand, but that product may not have the stable demand, and that's why this product may not need to have a special attention in terms of safety stock or in terms of replenishment planning. Similarly, you may have a product which is actually in a C category, that means its value for your business is very less. But this product has a stable demand, that means it is coming into X category of XYZ analysis. So you can actually give major attention on such products for keeping a safety stock or for automating your replenishment planning methods. So that is why this significance of ABC and XYZ combination creates the benefit in the decision making. Now let's take one example. Let's take this example of AX category. So this product is basically a high value product. So let's filter out that product in our ABC analysis. So we have filtered this product in our ABC analysis. So you can see that, you know, this product's demand is also stable. So we can see that actually in XYZ analysis. So data is same, but let's see where this product actually falls into. Okay, so this product is X category product for us, and this product is actually A category product for us. So this is basically a product whose value in terms of your entire inventory portfolio is on a higher side, as well as this product's demand is quite stable. So you can give special attention on such products because these are the products which give you continuous revenue, and these are the products which also generate higher inventory values for your business, and that's why having better control for such products is very much important. Now let's take second example of let's say AZ category. So we will take this example of this product. That means this product's value for your business is on a higher side. So I am just filtering this product. So you can see that this product's value on your business is actually in top. It is actually at 19% of your entire value. And as far as XYZ category is concerned, this product's demand is not very much stable. So you will see the stability of that this product's demand is very much like sporadic. So that's why such products may not be very much, you know, attention making for inventory professionals. Now let's take another example of similar in a similar line. So this is one classic example. You can see, okay, so you have seen that this product in XYZ, and let's put that in ABC analysis as well. So you will see that this product's demand is also very much sporadic throughout the year, but its inventory value is on a higher side because it so it is actually coming in top 50% of the items which are contributing your inventory in A class. So that's why this product does not need special attention in terms of keeping safety stocks or, you know, You may not need to give major attention on such products, even they are A category products. Now, since there are 9 different combinations of ABC and XYZ classification, so there are also 9 different actions that you should take for your business. And let's go to the action template. So in this template, you will see this is a class ABC on vertical axis, and on horizontal axis you will see class XYZ. Now, A and X products, these are the products which have highest value because they are A category, and these are products having stable demand because they are X category. So simply, it is high value stable product. Second is high value fluctuating demand. Third is high value and high fluctuation for these products. Now, these 9 categories give some insights. So these are some insights that you should follow, or you may create your own strategies based on ABC and XYZ categorization, based on your business nature, based on your product nature, and accordingly you can follow these strategies. So what my strategy for ABC and XYZ is, basically the product is A and X. That means it has a high value and high stability. So basically, good point is you should automate this product's replenishment. So you may use, automated replenishment methods like vendor managed inventory, min-max model that we will see in future. And in this product, you should actually keep safety stock. I would say you should keep safety stock with highest service level of the safety stock. That means a safety stock on little higher side. And you should have frequent cycle count. So any product which is actually A category, that should have a frequent cycle count. Now let's understand the product which is C and Z. So these are the products whose value for business is very less, and even they are into Z category. So in such products or such kind of products, you should not actually keep a safety stock. So you can create your own strategies for your business depending on the nature of your, ABC and XYZ classification. And below in ABC XYZ, you can see the graph of, or below you will see the overview of, your ABC and XYZ classification analysis. So out of 16,000 products, this is the contribution of A and X category. Then B and X category is basically 475 parts. And on right side, you will see basically percentage of their contribution. So 71% of your products are actually C class products, and they have a demand which is, sporadic in nature. So this is a template for ABC and XYZ classification. And again, on this table, whatever actions you see, these actions should be defined by you based on your business nature, based on your product natures, and based on the situation of your business, like cash flow or your inventory positioning and your, customers' requirements. So based on multiple situations, you should define your own strategies for ABC and XYZ classification.